Velkommen tilbage til pressemøde her på vores nye sportskanal TV3 Sport 2. Et pressemøde, der selvfølgelig handler om to giganters møde i London den 25. maj. Nemlig Mikkel Kessler og Carl Froch-Jesdorf. Det bliver stort.
Ej, det gør det. Vi var begge to over at se den første kamp over i Herning i 2010. Og det var simpelthen den mest dramatiske og mest velboksede kamp nogensinde i Danmark. Og vi tog det begge to. Vi får en til med en til
det
i London.
Det håbede vi i hvert fald.
Det bliver super dramatisk og forhåbentlig med ham, vi holder med, der vinder. Vi skal byde velkommen til vores første gæst, Mikkel, og Carl Froch kommer selvfølgelig senere i høj grad i det her program. Men det er promotor for Mikkel Kessler, Kalle Sauerland. Welcome to you. Jeg står lige over i engelsk. Kalle, tell us first, you have been working for this match, Froch-Kessler, for a month. It's one of your big dreams as a promoter. But a lot of people thought that the match would be against Andrew Ward, the American boxer. Why did it end up with Froch?
You know, I think, first of all, as a promoter, you look, what do the fans want? And of course, both the Ward fight or the Froch fight are massive, massive fights. And I think it boils back down to that at the time we had a very good conversation with Eddie Hearn, the promoter of Carl Froch. We got on very well, and you know, it was a difficult deal to put together. It's a huge fight involving a lot of networks, and it was, as we saw yesterday, the tickets are almost sold out, virtually sold out. I think there's a few left, but. Incredible response, and I think that shows the magnitude of this fight. And I felt it shows, of course, that the decision was the right one to take. We all know what happened in the first fight. It was such a close, brutal fight over 12 rounds. The greatest fight ever on Danish soil. One of the greatest fights of the year, and one that will go down in the history books. That we can't take away from either of the men already. And look, you know, they've agreed to do all this again, you know, which is... which is quite something, we're going to enter for the viewers and for us sitting at ringside and the people watching it on television. It's something very special to be able to see two guys who are going to war with each other and to go to places that a normal human being will never go. Mikkel Kessler and Carl Froch are warriors who in the first fight went to places physically, mentally, emotionally. You know, they left everything in the ring, and I think the second fight will literally take off from where we left it in the 12th round.
You have chosen the O2 Arena in London. Why?
Well, I think primarily it was a decision taken, obviously, from both sides. You know, we said we would honour Mikkel's promise to Carl to come to the UK. We looked at the biggest venues in the UK. It was Manchester in discussion. London was in discussion. But once you go to the O2 in London, you'll see why it's, for me, the best venue in the whole of Europe, if not the world. You know, and we've staged events everywhere from of course, the States to Russia, to Germany, to Denmark. And this venue is something special. It's very steep. Every seat is a great seat. You have a perfect view to the ring, even right at the top. And it's going to be a cauldron of atmosphere that night, and I'm sure there's a lot of Danish fans coming over. I know Carl Froch has got a huge following in the UK, as we saw yesterday. I mean, unfortunately, the tickets are, although we're only announcing it in Denmark today.
Are you surprised that they were sold out this fast?
You know, I knew it would be big, and actually, Eddie and myself were joking the week before. We were saying, oh, what do you reckon, half the tickets on the first day? And, you know, look, we've done 95% of the tickets are gone, you know, and there'll be a few hopefully coming back on the market later in the week, but at the moment, it's virtually sold out.
As you said, Kalle, you had a press conference in London in the arena yesterday, and you came on aeroplane to Denmark last night to the press conference today and all these shootings with being the photographers. And so it's a very big fight. It's almost sold out in London in this very big arena. Why do you think it is so big? Why do you think the interest almost in the States are so big about this match?
Well, I think it's just the storyline. It's two warriors who have done it before. We're going to do it again. The first one was very close. You know, Mikkel got the edge on it, but it was a very close fight. And hats off for Mikkel agreeing to do it again, for Carl doing it again. And, you know, both guys had other options, but this is what they want to do.
Aren't you afraid that Mikkel will lose it?
You know, I'm confident in my man. And I know what Mikkel can do. I know that Mikkel is one of the cleverest boxers we've ever worked with. I think it's an advantage for him as well that he's seen Carl. I think he was a little bit surprised with Carl's style last time. You know, but Carl will learn as well from the first fight. And, you know, I'm sure... Look, I'm not going to say that we're going to win this fight. I'm just saying we're confident. You know, it's a 50-50 fight.
Thank you so much for coming up here, Kalle. Now we have to send you down. You have to participate in the press conference in a minute. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Det er nemlig rigtigt, hvad Camilla siger, for nu er det tid til selve pressemødet, hvor repræsentanter for den danske presse, der er helt fyldt hernede, og også briterne er her for at stille spørgsmål til Frotch.
Der er også mange spørgsmål.
Ja, vi kommer også til at stille nogle af det. Hvad vil du spørge dem om?
Jamen, jeg har lagt mærke til én ting specielt, og det er, at vi mødte dem jo tidligere i dag, både Carl og Mikkel sammen, og de virker som om, de sådan har en intern forståelse af alle mulige ting. Men samtidig ved vi også godt, at de går til den, når de kommer op i ringen. Men vi skal da i hvert fald lige have at vide, om de i virkeligheden godt kan lide hinanden, eller er det spil for galleriet.
Vi kan roligt sige, at når de kommer op i ringen den 25. maj, så er de modstandere, så er de fjender. Men det er ikke sikkert, at deres fjendskaber også strækker til, når de sidder hernede bagved. Det vil vi høre om lidt, når Frotch og Kessler er til pressemødet. Eller faktisk nu, for vi kan jo kaste ordet ned til dig, og det er pressechef Johannes Behrendt. Værsgo.
Thank you very much. And on behalf of Matchroom Sports and Team Sauerland, I would like to welcome everybody here to this special press conference. It's the second leg of our two-day PR tour. Yesterday we were in London at the O2 Arena, and today we're here in Copenhagen. You know the gentleman and the lady on the podium, Carl Frotch, the IBF champion, Michael Kessler, WBA champion. They're joined by their promoters, Kalle Sauerland and Eddie Hearn, and of course the Viasat CEO, Jette Nygaard-Andersen. Welcome. We've heard from Kalle Sauerland already what kind of match this is. Very, very special. And let's hear it from Michael Kessler. Michael, why are you giving Carl this rematch?
I'm giving Carl this rematch because it's a match I never got myself from Joe Calzaghe. And that's why. And he's a good fighter. And it was a close fight we had in Denmark. So I think it's to be a man and to be a fair fighter to come to his home turf and fight him there.
You have fought and traveled all over the world, but still it takes something special and the heart of a champion to go to London to fight a popular hero like Carl Frotch with 17,000 fans in attendance. This must be very special.
Yes, of course it's special. I tried it before, and I know there's going to be a big crowd against me. I hope, of course, there's going to be a lot of Danish fans coming over. And but that's how it is. Carl, he did the same thing. He came to Denmark and took the challenge. Now it's my turn to take the challenge over there, and I'm ready for it. To show him and show the boxing fans that I am the better super middleweight champion.
Thank you, Mikkel. Question for you, Carl. Mikkel thinks he's the better super middleweight. I'm sure you would disagree on that.
Do I need a microphone? No, obviously not. hello, everybody. Thanks for coming. I've got to say that Michael Kessler, you know, he's a great, great champion. He's a great fighter. And I think between Michael Kessler and myself, we are the best super middleweights in the world. And that takes into account all the other super middleweights from the Super Six, Andre Ward. I know he's got a decision over Michael Kessler and me in the final of the Super Six. I lost to Ward, but he's not a fighting man. Michael Kessler is a fighter. He'll stand and he'll fight like a real man. And you said earlier, he didn't need to come to England. He doesn't need to come to England. He could stay in Denmark, comfortably defending his title. I could stay in Nottingham, comfortably defending my title. But I said to Eddie, my promoter, the fight I want is Mikel. The fight the fans want, the fight the broadcasters want is Mikel. And for me, to be given the opportunity to take away the blemish on the record, which is a loss to this great champion, it's an opportunity that I'm grateful for Mikel. And I'm going to be a proud, honourable man, represent myself, my country, and do everything I can to win this fight. But you can see round 12 there, we're showing it on the screens. That's how the fight was from about round 4 or 5. It's going to be a toe-to-toe, brutal fight. Vicious, and a fight that could go either way. I'm going into the fight thinking I'm going to win the fight and knowing what I need to do to win. But I'm fully aware that this fight could go either way. That's how close this fight is. We're almost the same height. We've almost got the same reach. I've got a bit longer arms than Mikel. We've been sizing each other up. We both punch hard and we can both take a good shot on the chin. So this is just going to be exciting for everybody involved.
A few of the words that have been flying around, also coming from you, were brutal, savage, wild, and war. What makes you think you can win this war, and what have you learned from the first fight?
Well, since the first fight, I've had some very, very, very big fights. You know, I continued through the Super Six. I beat Glankoff Johnson. I lost a close decision to Andre Ward. And then I became three-time world champion by beating Lucien Bute from Canada. A lot of people didn't think I could win that fight. I obviously put it on him from round one. Aggressive, lots of raiding attacks, plenty of punches, combinations coming from 6-8 punch combinations. You know, and I learned a lot mentally and physically where I need to be when I fight at world championship level. So every time I step through them ropes, it's important for me to make sure I'm in 100% good shape. And if I get into the ropes with anybody in the world, I feel I can beat anybody in the world. I'm aware that I can also be beat because I've been beaten in close fights. This fight was in Denmark. Mikael Kester's honouring me with the rematch in England. And I just think it's going to be different. You know, I'm confident. I'm sure Mikael Kester is. And that's why this fight's going to be so interesting, so entertaining.
Very interesting indeed. I heard yesterday from the reporters at the press conference, they said this might be the biggest fight in London in 20 years. Eddie, could you talk about what this fight means to Britain and to the fight fans in the United Kingdom?
Well, we saw yesterday from the response from the fans with the tickets. You know, I don't think there's been a faster selling gate in UK boxing perhaps ever than Froch Kesler 2. You know, sold over 15,000 tickets just yesterday. Probably in 2 or 3 hours, and unfortunately there's tickets going on eBay and with touts for 5, 6, 7 times, you know, the asking price, and that's a tribute to the size of the show. It happens in all mega shows, but you know, this is a fight really that the public want to see. You know, Karl Froch over the last year, particularly through the Lucien Bute performance, has become the biggest name in British boxing, bar none. And, you know, the Brits, they've got a little soft spot in their heart for Mikael Kesler because, like Karl said, he is a fighter, he is a warrior. They love the way he fights. And his mother is from England as well, you know, which some of the reporters pointed out yesterday. He was very, you know, he was quick to tell everyone that yesterday, but not so quick to tell people that today, you know. But no, but seriously, you know, it's you've seen the response, and the response, obviously, from the broadcasters. This is going to be on HBO in America as well, which is, again, a credit to the fight itself. And the whole of Britain can't wait. This is the kind of fight that boxing needs, you know. And these guys are great because they sit in the green room chatting and, you know, they're friendly to each other. But they know that in 4 months' time, they're going to have a pair of shorts on and they're going to be going to war with each other all over again.
The fight will be on pay-per-view in Denmark, and Viasat has been dedicated to boxing for a very long time. Can you tell us what makes boxing so special for a major broadcaster like Viasat?
Well, you know, Viasat is the biggest Danish sports broadcaster. We have more than 8,000 hours of live sports each year. And as you say, I mean, we've been passionate about boxing since the late 90s, I think, where we start showing boxing. And we had the first pay-per-view match, actually, with Brian Nielsen and Tyson, I think it was in 2001. So this is hard blood for us. Even today, we launched a new TV channel, which will have a lot of focus also on boxing. So we're extremely proud to be able to present, you know, not only boxing, but a match like this with the two biggest boxers. And of course, it's also when we have, you know, Mikael Kesler as a great, great sportsman and then a great, great boxer. It's extremely important for us to be able to bring that match to the Danish audience.
So we have the match in Denmark, also on pay-per-view in England, on HBO. Kalle, as a promoter, this fight must be as good as it gets.
Well, I think the reaction of the fans says it all, you know, like I said up there. You know, it's one of those clashes that really is going back in time almost. It's, you know, it's not about, of course, it's about two belts, it's about a unification, but really it's a throwback to let's say, the golden years of boxing. I mean, we always talk about these golden years of boxing. There is great boxing at the moment as well, but it really reminds me of a vintage fight. You know, it's something which we saw in the first fight. You know, there's not really many gimmicks about it. I mean, I know in the first one, me and Karl had a bit of a run-in before, and I think there was a bit of drama around that in the press conferences, and you know. But to be honest with you, we don't need to sell this. You know, I said yesterday at the press conference, I said all you need to do is look over there, look at the screen, and look at Froch Kesler 1. And that's the selling point. It's not about me and Eddie sitting here and saying, you know, my guy's better than your guy, and you know, Mick will say, I'm going to do this, or Karl say, I'm going to do that. It's about boxing, and it's about going to war with each other. And you know, we don't need to con anyone here. You've seen the first fight, and that's what it's all about.
Thank you very much. And with that, we'll take some questions from the floor.
All at once.
Yeah. You state your name and affiliation, please.
Jens Ilesen, Knockout DK. It's a question for Karl Froch. Analyzing your previous matches, against Mikkel Kessler and Andrew Ward. You were pushed backwards, also earlier fights like Charles Adamu. It seems like you are a more dangerous fighter when you are allowed to step forward. Would you agree on that?
Potentially. I mean, I think 95% is all more dangerous when they're allowed to come forward, because when they're coming forward, they're being offensive and it's a fight. And if you can go forward with your shots and let your shots go, you're on your front foot, there's more power in your shots. So it depends who you're in front of. You know, if your opponent's not going to let you come forward, then you have to back off and you have to move and use your ring. I mean, that's why it's boxing and not fighting. It's the art of pugilism. So yeah, 95% of fighters are better going forward because it means they're taking control and they're dominating the fight. So I would agree with that, yeah.
Further questions? Well, if there are no further questions, I think we can proceed with a picture, and we'll make a face-to-face picture right here. And I would ask Carl and Mikkel, please, to take their belts and face off right in front of the podium.
It's on that side.
It's okay.
Face to face
first,
and into the cameras.
Det var altså selve pressemødet, og lige om et øjeblik, så kommer altså både Mikkel Kessler og Carl Flotz her op til os to. Og yes, jeg kan ikke lade være med at tænke på, at vi har snakket meget om det her, det selvfølgelig bliver en outstanding kamp, når vi når til 25. maj. Men på en eller anden måde, at høre de der gutter sidde deroppe og snakke, der synes jeg, det bliver slået fast med 7-tommer-søm, hvad det er, vi skal se i The O2 Arena den 25.
Ja, for det er jo ikke bare sådan en bragesnak fra promoter, der skal prøve at sælge den her kamp, som jo handler om at sælge mange billetter. Man kan simpelthen høre, at dels er den solgt til alle mulige lande, og der er næsten fyldt, altså der er solgt stort set samlet 17.000 billetter i London på en enkelt dag, og det er en kamp, som har ekstrem interesse ude omkring i verden. Og ved du, jeg også synes, det er meget sjovt at se, det er, som vi snakkede om, det er den der vanvittige respekt, som Kessler har for Frotch, og Frotch har for Kessler. Især Frotch siger, at de er de to bedste mellemvægtsboksere overhovedet i verden. Bedre end Ward og bedre end alle de andre.
Ward, han bliver på en eller anden mærkelig måde sådan lidt en parentes i dag, synes jeg. Altså, de føler, tror jeg virkelig, de har leveret det, de skal til boksesporten, og nu gør de det en gang mere.
Ja, og de har godt nok begge to tabt til Ward, men de mener jo, de gjorde det på sådan nogle præmisser. Han er sådan lidt en gadedreng, han bokser kun på hjemmebane, han er på kanten af at være en tøsedreng. Det her, det er rigtige mænd, som tager møde hinanden, næsten på neutral grund, som vi hørte Frotch kalde det, for de mødes ikke i Nottingham, som er hans hjemby, men i London, efter at de havde den første kamp i Herning. Så de har en kæmpe respekt for hinanden, og de er begge to klar over, altså selvfølgelig er en af dem taber, men der er ingen, der er sikker på at vinde kampen.
Nej, de virker i hvert fald ret afklaret med, at det hele det skal afgøres formentlig i 12. omgang. Vi hørte også Carl Flotz omtale den der 12. famøse omgang. Jes, hvad kunne du godt tænke dig at spørge dem om, når nu de kommer herop og besøger os lige om lidt? Vi har allerede talt om, jeg godt lige vil vide det der med, at de har et godt forhold til hinanden. Hvad kunne du godt tænke dig at vide?
Ja, dels hvor godt er det forhold, de har til hinanden indtil den 25. maj, når de skal bokse der. Men jeg lagde også mærke til under pressemødet, at Carl Frotch, han sidder, mens Mikkel taler, og kigger over på en skærm i siden af, han nævnte det også, hvor 12. omgang fra Herning i 2010 kører. Og jeg kan se, han sidder og kigger derovre og siger, hvad kan jeg lære af den? Hvad var det, jeg gjorde galt? For han fik virkelig klø i 12. omgang, som afgjorde, at Kessler vandt på point.
Det er den vildeste omgang, jeg nogensinde har set i boksning, og den kommer vi også til at se nærmere på senere i udsendelsen. Nu skal vi lige have en kort pause, men når vi vender tilbage her på vores nye sportskanal, TV3 Sport 2, jamen så er det både med Mikkel Kessler og Carl Flotz, og måske er der andre, der også har lyst til at tale med os, Jes. Man ved jo aldrig.
Ej, vi glæder os til at snakke med verdens to klogeste boksere.